Hartley here with you, and today we'll be looking at some After Effects effects that I've used in my intro for my tutorials. I had a couple of people ask me how I went about doing that, and I decided that I can just show you. That way you have a few more effects in your After Effects arsenal. So we'll start off with a new composition, and while I'm doing this, just basic settings here, and I'm going to make solid. Music is a very big part of your intro. You really gotta decide what type of music you're gonna use before you start, and then you can just kind of go from there. So if you have a fast moving song like hip hop or dubstep or chiptune, whatever is fast to you, then that's really gonna kind of set the mood for your intro. So I'll go ahead and get started here. Just add one word. And the way I did this in my opener is probably not the best way. I'll show you how to do it this way, and I'll try to come up with a better way later on, now that I've learned a little more along the way. But to start, we're just going to go with one word, and we're going to do that same effect. Oh, appear to be zooming in. Fit up to 100%. There we go. And basically do the effect to just one word, and then you can just duplicate that and move it around on the timeline, and everything looks pretty good. To tell you a little bit about this spot, it's Matryoshka, or however you pronounce that, some Russian gymnast last name. But one of the things to notice here is that I'm using stroke over fill instead of fill over stroke, and at first I didn't remember what I did to get this cool black outline, but again, it's a stroke over fill instead of fill over stroke. So that's something you can play around with your different fonts. So we will go ahead and make this a 3D object and hit R for rotation, and we're just going to change the orientation, and basically we want it to kind of pop up. And to start that, we want it to be almost flat, and we'll go forward a little bit, and we'll bring that back to zero, and so now we have this looking guy right there. And one thing to notice here, we'll go back over to my original composition, is that it looks like it's rotating down. So how did I do that? I did that by changing the position, which is not necessarily, again, the best way to do it, but it worked in this scenario. And I'll hit Shift R to bring back up my orientation. And okay, so start the position off up here. And then bring it down back to where it started. So now we get this little rotation effect. Pretty sweet, huh? And we'll go ahead and create another keyframe right there. Go forward just a little bit, and we will bump this all the way down off the screen. And ta-da, we have the first one. You can adjust the opacity right here to make sure that it's not showing right away, because you can see a little sliver right there in the middle. So we'll bump that opacity down to zero. And move forward just a hair, bring it up to 100. And so that way it's completely hidden before we bring it in. All right, so now we will go ahead and duplicate that. So Command D or Control D, I think is the PC version. Yes, so we have that duplicated, and now we can move it forward. Let's see where all these were. You can hit U on the keyboard as keyboard shortcut. See all of the things that you're manipulating with keyframes. And so that's really probably one of my favorite keyboard shortcuts. Okay, so we have this moved up, and we have the word that's going to come in, but we want the other word to kind of stay there. Let's see. Hold shift to move to that keyframe. Like, as this word is coming in, so this is just gonna have to be something that you try a couple different times. Let me zoom in on my timeline. You can zoom in on the timeline by pressing the plus key. And probably move that forward one more. Oh, backward one more. There we go. So it kind of looks like it's bumping that out. Not completely, but you see that there's a little bit of a disconnect here in between those two words. But you kind of get where the general effect is going. So now we have cool beans, comes down, gets pushed out, and you have next cool beans, and we'll change that to potatoes. And we'll have to change that positioning just a little bit. Make sure you hover, or you go to the keyframe that you actually have, and move that over to the center. Same thing with this guy, move it over to the center. And actually, the easier way is to find out where you're centering it right there. So 608, we'll bump up to over here, and 608. Over here, 608, and here finally, 608. Okay, so we have cool beans, potatoes, and we'll do one more. Actually, you know what? No, we're not going to do one more. We're going to move on to the second part, which is take a look at Multimedia Fun Times, comes down, just another rotation, just like usual, and then gets bumped out. So, we're going to go straight to that effect. So instead of potatoes going down, it's going to move off to the right. And to do that, we will get one more word in here. Potatoes. Cheese. And move that up off the screen. Hit P for position. Make a keyframe. Make a 3D object as well. And then we'll start to move it onto the screen. Right there. Whoop. Need to move that forward just a hair. We'll replace it right there. So now you got to find out where it's starting to hit potatoes. So right there. And so move a keyframe back. You can hit command and then arrow to the left or an arrow to the knee if you were once an adventurer. Sorry, that's a terrible joke. So now we can go ahead and move forward a little bit. And potatoes is going to fly off the screen there. All right. So it takes a little finesse and a little finagling, but you get the general idea of how to bump text off the screen. So potatoes, cheese, potatoes, cheese, potatoes, cheese. Is that overlapping at all? It's overlapping a little bit, but that's how I did it in my intro. So that is that. Everything else is just some fade effects. Oh, and also motion blur. Motion blur is one of the best effects for your text, because as it's moving, if you make quick movements, it will kind of blur that as it's coming down. So the faster things get, the more flow there is, because you're getting this blur effect without having to actually go into, you know, Gaussian blur or something like that. So I tend to have motion blur on all the time for any text opener that I do. So there's a quick look at how I made my intro. Hopefully that gave you some extra information that you didn't have before. Let me know if you have any comments or questions, and also if you have any more ideas for tutorials. Thanks for watching, guys, and until next time, I'm John Hartley.